Warning, the following video contains strong language which may be offensive to some viewers and or inappropriate for children. The content within this video is intended for mature audiences only. In other words, Anonymous can't handle his liquor.
Talk about the fact that we fucked up the first half of the pod. Like, that is what it is. That's realistic. It's a part of the podcast game. Hey, we had some technical difficulties, y'all, and now we had to restart.
Ain't none of the cameras started. What we doing? But we can't do nothing with the audio if the camera's not rolling. Huh?
That camera rolling. Do your thing, man. And we back. Do it.
All right, man.
Do the thing.
Welcome back to that the second is. Try. A live from the live. Episode 34, man.
Yeah, y'all about to get a real episode now, y'all.
Man, if y'all knew what we just went through.
Man, hey. God saves his.
I had to cuss niggas out, y'all. Anonymous had to cuss niggas out.
Anonymous, a damn lie.
Bro.
I had to cuss niggas out, y'all.
Anonymous lying his ass off.
So to sum up what just happened, Anonymous messed up the audio from the whole first half. That
bullshit.
We just did.
Bullshit. So, bullshit.
Know. Word of the day is accountability.
Right.
Come on.
Exactly. Bullshit. Bullshit. All right,
man. So let's get into it, man.
Word of the day. Nah. Fuck all that.
We got Taz crafted.
Word of the day is bullshit. Cause these niggas is a bunch of
Bizzle in the building, man.
Bullshit.
Turn my mic down.
And we got DJ Double R in the building.
DJ Double R, bullshit. Bullshit.
Oh, y'all about to get a real
bullshit.
Here we go.
Him drunk.
Yeah, y'all can tell. But how he talking
hold on,
over
hold on,
there,
hold on,
how he
on.
Messed up the first
go,
half.
Go ahead. Next person.
All right, man. Let's get it.
Taz crafted. Bullshit.
Hit my applause again.
Bullshit.
I'm in ran my introduction back.
Bullshit.
There you go.
Bullshit.
All right, bro. Golly.
Iconic in the building. Bullshit.
Right. Get him out of here, man. So let's get into this music, man. Hold on.
DJ Double R.
We're going to take it back one time, man, to probably one of the last periods of when the Migos were still together, man. Let's get into this.
Okay,
one.
Don't mute my mic, bitch. Y'all is on bullshit. You hear me?
Oh, yeah. We up right now, y'all. It's real live from the lab.
Niggas is on bullshit.
We on live. Yeah.
Round on that clock, plus other when you driving the push top. It. I push a button now, I can't stop. I'm doing donuts, turning another
push
five.
It.
Staying five down at the spot.
Big shots up the club right
push
now.
Push it.
All the trip, bitch, lost.
Get that 42 together.
Push it.
I made a 4-3.
Get that dude set together, baby.
I'm like Picasso, I paint me
push a portrait.
Getting money, taking drugs with
all. Get all that to my section, let's go.
I started. I need to try to get a fuck by virus. Got a flock of 10 like an arsenal. This shit making the nigga phenomenal. Put the energy on the elevator.
Good shit.
Man, shout out to all the paper getters. Y'all already know, man. Good people, good vibes, good energy. Live from the lab, man. It's live from the lab.
What a way to start this episode, man.
Whole bunch of bullshit going on.
All right, bro. God, YouTube. This man done said 50 curse words within the first minute. Chill out.
Uh-oh.
Bullshit.
You knew what you did when you did that.
Look at this. Here we go.
Let me tell y'all something, man. They make Duce real good, man.
It's a lot of sugar.
Got
in
to.
That.
Yeah.
Got to.
Yeah. That thing is distilled. How do they make that? How long it take to make it? They make it, boy. They really.
We should do a podcast where we do reviews on liquor.
I like that.
Let's start with you.
It's a whole lot of hate going on.
Let's start with you. How does Deuce say?
But it's a whole lot of bullshit going on too.
Man, speaking of niggas wilding on cognac, Katt Williams was on Shannon Sharp going crazy. Yeah. Oh, y'all like that little transition? Yeah. Oh, y'all like that?
That was fire.
Little Euro stuff.
He definitely was telling the truth.
Hey, man. He was out here. Like, at the end of the day, we all know, man, the fake out here is going to get killed in 2024, like I already said in a previous podcast that we had. So we going to run it like that. Like, look, Katt Williams stepped out here. He said what he said. Ain't nobody come back and call him a liar whatsoever. So.
Yeah, I don't think they could because the internet did their research, you know, and found all of the old clips.
Undefeated. Internet's undefeated, man.
What he was talking about.
Yo.
And put side by side, literally timelining it to prove Katt Williams' point.
Did you see all the wives together? No disrespect to no man's wives. I'm not trying to say it like that. But he said that they was all with light skin, with wide faces.
Yeah.
And then they was all... Like, I mean, beautiful women, don't get me wrong. Like, some of the most pretty women in the world has white. Rihanna has a wide face, and she likes skin. But it's crazy.
Man, she likes skin.
Don't try to put Rihanna in that bush.
I'm saying, like, but she would fall in that bucket, too. So it's not like he's saying that the women are unattractive, but it's just kind of, like, is that like a starter kit when you get popping in the industry? Because, I mean, like.
It might be. I think he said it come with the contract, right?
I mean, I'm saying, Tone, we trying to get up out of here, so.
That's what he said, I think. Well, I think he said that was in the terms and conditions.
Yeah, but he also went to say a lot more that was in the terms and conditions.
Yeah. We ain't going to repeat that, but, you know. If you want to know what we talking about, go watch the interview.
And apparently, now he got Kevin Hart's wife on tour with him.
Ex-wife?
Ex-wife.
She's still a heart though.
Hey, what is that about though? What?
I mean, that's.
Is she even funny? No, I'm dead ass. I've never heard a joke from her. Didn't even know she did stand up. Like, is this like some? What is this some type?
Oh wait, oh she. Oh, she's a stand up.
I don't know. What else would she be on tour with this nigga for?
Man, I thought he was pulling a Rick Ross. Like when you beef with somebody, you just go get that baby mom. Sometimes, like yo, that's rap beef.
I don't know. I didn't know nothing about it.
Nah, like apparently she is on tour with Katt Williams now.
Boom. So on tour is what? She gotta act in the show?
Well, I mean
Katt Williams.
Or she just gonna be with him.
She better be funny because he did say in an interview that he only put people on who he think are funnier than him.
True. I guess we're gonna see. Y'all going to the... He got one of the Bojangles Coliseum. Yeah, I'm about to say.
We might got to step in there. Might got to see what they talking about.
Hey, pod trip. We going to trip for the fellas.
We might
gonna
have
see Katt Williams.
No Doucet.
Got to leave the Doucet at the house.
We got a limited anonymous on the Doucet.
Bullshit.
Here we go.
here we go.
Bullshit.
Here we go, y'all.
Lord, yeah, we got to have an anonymous cam eventually.
Yeah, we do.
We going to bag you.
We can't be anonymous forever.
We going to bag you one day.
Come on, right.
Look, though, so I was thinking about this the other day, right?
Tone thoughts. Let's go.
So growing up, did y'all have family members that would kiss y'all in the mouth when y'all was kids?
Pause.
Like, you mean like a smooch? Like, not like a...
Yeah. I mean, not of course. Come on, bro. Why would I be thinking
clarify
about that?
On that?
I said as a kid. Why would I think anything other?
I'm
than
just
that?
Saying because everybody. I was explaining for everybody
damn,
who had a woe to say. I was like, what?
Dad better not kiss me in my mouth.
Yeah, I don't kiss my son.
Now, I don't remember my mom's kissing me in my mouth. Like at a time I could remember her doing it.
Maybe when I was a baby.
So
a fucking baby.
As a grown up, I understand why you don't kiss me in my mouth.
Right. Okay, we're good. None of us experienced that.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
You say on my breath, baby.
Yeah, right.
You hear me?
It's Zon Duce. That's why we don't kiss.
Might need a designated driver. You kiss
what?
Boy, you
designated driver
up.
After kissing someone is crazy.
Oh, boy.
That's worse than a contact guy.
For real. But it's a good thing, you know, that none of us experienced that. But, you know, that's pretty common, though. Like, a lot of parents kiss their babies even into, like, kid years, like 5 years old, kiss them in the mouth. A lot of parents do that.
That's weird.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if I ever really kissed my daughter in her, like, in her mouth fully.
In,
like,
in the mouth is wow.
Like, nah.
There
like,
are parents that do that, though. Believe me.
Oh, that's weird. I mean, that's wait, awesome.
So is it weird if the mom is doing it with the son? Like, on yeah, some...
I wasn't getting specific.
Like, I'm not saying it like that. I'm saying it like...
I think it's weird across the board.
Right. It's weird. Right. I'm just asking. I don't know.
Yeah. It's wow.
We don't do that in my family.
Right.
We don't do that.
I feel like lip to
and
lip
that
is
that goes
like,
back to me. Saying as a grown up, you know what you do as a grown up. Why is you kissing your child in the mouth?
Okay. All right,
I see where he's going.
Don't be doing that.
Yeah.
Because
that is
wild.
Don't be doing that. Like, don't be doing that. Just a kiss on the cheek is cool.
I was about to say, what about a mom kissing her daughter or something? Like,
I mean, not if mommy just went crazy in the mouth.
In the mouth, though. In the mouth.
I would hope not.
In the mouth is wow. Kissing your
child. That's why I was asking,
because
is it a difference when a mom is doing it with a son and a mom is doing it with her daughter?
It don't matter. I feel as though kissing a child in the mouth in general is wow.
I think Anonymous is saying that like grown up mouths do grown up things.
Grown up mouths do grown up things. You feel me?
You know what I'm saying?
I feel it. But I,
we
I
really
get
to it.
I guess I can see both sides.
If you watching right now, let us know, man. If you grew up and your parents kissed
my family,
you
put
mouth,
that in the comments.
You know, hey.
Let us know how you feel about that.
Make sure you brush your teeth a little. If your parents kissing in your mouth, you hear me?
That is crazy. Wild. That's
ain't
a crazy
it,
take on
ain't
it.
Enough toothbrushes in the world, boy.
Not at all. All right, so look, we're going to go into these tone-deaf questions. Appreciate that name.
I see what he did. Yeah, tone-deaf.
So I got like three more for us this like week. That. You know what I mean? The first one is...
It's a way better DJ name, too.
Facts, though.
Yeah, all right.
All right, so...
My royalties. Let's go.
What would you call a male ladybug?
A ladybug.
Gary. I don't know.
I don't know.
It's a ladybug.
A ladybug.
It's a ladybug. Like, I don't think ladybugs have a gender.
You know, they definitely have a gender. You think it's only male ladybug? How would they make more ladybugs?
Are they genderless?
It don't concern me. It's a ladybug.
Wait, you don't think ladybugs is out here fucking?
Oh wow.
I don't know what a male ladybug look like. To be like, able to fuck a ladybug. Right. I know what a
ladybugs have dicks.
Like.
That's crazy.
Hold on, wait.
A ladybug is a ladybug, my nigga. Like, you're not about to confuse me.
No, that's just the name of the bug. Like, there's female sperm whales too.
A ladybug is a ladybug.
Right, but that's just the name of the bug. Like, it's not the gender of the bug.
The ladybug was sleeping with the other ladybug, and that's how they made more ladybugs.
That is how it works, sir. There you go. Congratulations.
Ladybug. You feel me? Like, that's a confusing ass question. What do you call a male ladybug?
Hey, yo.
Like a male ladybug, like be for real.
And this is why, you know, when you get older kids, stay away from alcohol.
A male ladybug, though.
Alcohol is crazy.
Drunk Uncle Anonymous.
All right, number two.
That's drunk a dumbass question.
God damn, Uncle Anonymous.
Number two.
Oh, he's messing up the questions.
Dun dun dun.
Okay, got sound effects.
All right, here we go. Number two.
Come
do
on.
Do you know how to fold a fitted sheet?
Oh my God.
No.
I'm ashamed to say no.
Hey, I have no clue.
I'm sitting here thinking, like, no.
You could try and fold that shit as much as you want. That shit's still going to look
like it's like the corners never want to get folded.
No. This is too round. I can't.
Right. Like, the corners never want to get folded.
Hey, I'm not even fumbling with that.
Hey, I would love to see you try to fold that shit off the Douce.
I be trying.
Nigga be fighting.
Hey, I be trying.
If you know how to fold the fitted sheet, man, we need you to pull up and do that on live.
Send the video with, please. I need to see this done.
Hey,
probably
wifey trials. You know what I'm saying? A wife right. tryouts. Like, I need
hey,
to
if you can fold a fitted sheet, you a woman for me.
You ain't folding that. You just like
if she can fold a fitted like, sheet, that's my type of lady.
Feel like you different. You standing on different business. Push shit down. Literally.
Damn, she take care of the household, don't she?
Right. You be so amazed. You see a woman fold the fitted sheet.
Like, oh no, she didn't.
The bar is in hell.
Bet.
Bar is in absolute hell. God damn. That's what's gonna do it. Golly. Hey ladies, it's no easier time.
We're desperate.
Jeez, like do something out the ordinary. God.
Hey, bro, I like it.
All right, number three.
What's up?
What's the most embarrassing place you farted at before?
God damn, boy.
Oh, wow.
Church, while they was praying.
That's tough. That's tough and disrespectful.
That might literally be blasphemy. Like,
that's tough and disrespectful. Wow.
It was, that's crazy.
It was on the accident.
Like, we're talking to God. You could have held your cheeks.
I tried.
Pause. Thank you, Connick.
Hey, yo. Connick, there you go.
Connick hit him with crazy pause.
There you go.
Cross one pause.
Hey, yo.
I'm the first one to make Iconic do that.
All right, so Anonymous said history. Church while they was praying. What you got, Bill?
I'm going to say maybe, like, I don't know, in the football field.
Ain't that wild.
Niggas tackling me. I'm plotting and shit. Yeah. I know niggas sick. I'm like, my fault, y'all. Get above me, though.
I'm trying to think, like.
That's embarrassing to me. I don't know.
You said the craziest place?
This man said the football.
What? That's why I just.
I don't just be farting my ass off everywhere I go.
What niggas is doing out there? Like, what?
In the wide open field.
Boy.
You asked me the craziest place, Tone. What am I supposed to say? When we make some shit up?
That would have been a better answer.
In the elevator with Holly Berry.
Okay. Oh, now you just
yeah. Now I'm really fake with it.
What you got?
I think the hell? Probably aisle 8 at Trader Joe's.
No. I got another one for you.
You a nasty nigga.
Facts.
What is going on?
This one just came to mind.
Okay.
I was on the airplane. Fucked it up.
That's tough though. On the airplane is kind of crucial though.
Nobody can go nowhere.
That's in closed space, dude. Mm.
Hey.
50,000 feet in the air, smelling ass.
And he was in first class, so he cropped us in the whole
back.
All the way back.
The whole back of the plane smelled that one.
What? It's dirty.
My bad.
Dirty anonymous nigga.
Nah, mine probably is like in school when we was taking a test. Everybody quiet.
You got on me about football field, and you say that bullshit.
Boo.
Say that shit again, Tay. What was you saying earlier?
Bullshit. What the fuck was that? Bullshit.
I'm about to mute you again.
All right, y'all. Back to the Tone and Taz show.
Right. Yeah.
That's crazy.
Oh, man.
Is there another one? Do you have another one?
No, that was it. Only three.
Yo, I got a crazy question. A question I was thinking about the other day. Where, like, what region or what area do y'all think the girls have the sexiest accent from? What y'all think? What place has the best, like,
I ain't gonna lie to you,
accent?
When I was a little
global, or
I'm talking
when I was young,
all around the world. You know what I'm saying?
When I heard Estelle talk, wherever she from?
Estelle. Oh, from like England?
Yeah.
Oh.
When I heard Estelle talk, I was.
You like a fancy joint. Yeah.
What did you say? Say that again.
I feel you.
Lord.
I feel you.
I'm not going to lie.
What you thinking?
I'm ghetto fabulous.
Where you going?
Southeast D.C.?
Nah.
What's up, Mo?
Nah.
He like a girl that talked to him like his brother.
That's wild.
That's crazy.
Whoa.
So New York.
What are you saying?
I'm not going to New York.
So
I'm
women
sorry.
From New York then, okay.
I'm going south to like the, what's up, baby?
Definitely New
York. Oh, like Louisville.
Yeah.
Okay.
You get me?
Okay.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Yeah.
I need that, baby.
That shit might get annoying after a little while.
Oh, no. Call me baby.
Put that root on your ass, boy.
Hey, right. Hey.
Put spaghetti, baby. Put a pin in your whoopee cushion, right. Boy. Be out here.
As long as she hit me with that baby.
Now he on the strip doing a little mannequin job.
Damn, boy.
You got me.
hey, the mannequin challenge. You got me.
Oh, wow.
I'm gonna go like Caribbean.
Yeah, I was about to say whatever.
I feel like the closer you get to the equator, the crazier it gets. Yeah. Like that's like the better the accent gets, the closer you get.
That's all cool too though. I ain't gonna lie. What I'm saying? Like a Jamaican accent.
Yeah,
that's that down south New Orleans shit.
I can understand what they saying a little bit too much. Like in an accent, like I wanna barely be able to, like I wanna really have to listen. Like what is
this? Them motherfuckers.
My father, nah bro, you don't wanna hear that shit because you're not gonna understand it unless you around it a lot. My father from Barbados, and when he used to yell.
Oh, y'all like to understand what y'all like, saying. Okay.
It's like when I was younger, I used to be like, nigga, what? What are you saying?
My fault, y'all like to understand what girls are saying.
Hell yeah.
My bad.
She can't be saying, because that's like saying you want to hear a Spanish. Would you pick a Spanish girl?
Facts. What are you talking about?
You can't understand what she's saying,
though. I ain't going to lie. When I go get my toes done, I don't like when they motherfucking be talking a different language.
Oh, you know they talking
about
shit about your feet.
You hear me? I don't like that shit. I'm like, listen.
Now that you walking the line,
hey,
boy.
listen.
Are they be talking to you?
Tell me something that I can understand, because you know
they say they gonna hurt your feelings. You might want to fight.
If my shit fucked up, tell me my shit fucked up. You know what I mean?
That's bad business. Mm-mm. They're not gonna do
I'm
that.
I'ma still pay.
You spend good money in there. They gonna tell you your shit
still,
fine. You
I'm
fine.
Still pay.
You fine.
Man, they be just talking with the mad mean tone with anonymous toes in there. Like,
fuck no. They be like,
in no way.
They be like,
that boy got blocks of wood with his toes.
They like, my
they
God.
Like accent, bro. They don't like you.
They gotta pull out the sander for
I'm oh, saying.
Lord.
Look, bring honey. Switchblade.
I wonder who's gonna hit the accent. Biz was trying to get canceled. Go ahead, dog.
Oh, look, shit.
Nah, I was going to say, I like, what's her name, accent? Ooh. I don't know where she from. Tyler, the girl that sang Water. Y'all ever heard her talk?
Oh, yeah. She's like African, ain't she?
Something like that, I guess. I don't know. I like her accent.
You got to be more. I don't know. I got to understand. Where is she from?
Mm-hmm. All right, like, what's the worst accent, though? Mm. What girl's got the worst one? I think it's Boston. Y'all heard a shorty from Boston talk?
I'm about to say, when did you meet
like,
a girl
I don't
Boston?
Like New York women.
A little harsh.
Oh, don't say it like that. Come on, bro. We just cleaned up shit. You're doing good.
Fuck all that.
Accent. Don't say the girls. Like, what?
Across the board, you're judging them like that, man?
Yes.
Come on, man.
That's tough.
It's too aggressive.
That's crazy. Well, y'all
don't
not
tell,
only
don't
do he
tell.
Not like y'all accent, he just don't like y'all, period.
They go out to New York.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
They go out to New York. Hey, man.
Anonymous, don't fuck with me if you from New York.
But I mean, they accent cool. It's just a little rough. They a little rough around the edges.
Yeah, a lot of rough around the edges.
It ain't no different from no D.C. girl.
Bullshit.
Very close.
What?
Bullshit.
You what?
Prettier.
You
still,
serious?
Still as tough.
Go get smart with a PG County girl. See what happen. See what type of feedback
they
you get back.
They ain't on that New York
okay.
shit.
Okay. They trying to be like them. They talk just like them.
Oh, no.
Yeah, all right.
All right. Well, Bizzle, what's going on? We got some North Carolina news.
Uh-oh. NC news.
What's going
man,
on
whole,
in the streets of Carolina
of,
right now?
A whole lot of cap.
Oh.
Whole lot of cap is what I'm getting out of it. But apparently there was news. I don't even know the girl's name.
We ain't even gonna shout out. We ain't
yeah, we ain't even gonna do that. We ain't even get no free. Cause that's whack.
Oh man, what she do?
She was lying, going around saying some guy was giving her HIV and gave it to 7 different girls. She was making a fake text between her and herself, like she was these other girls coming out saying, "Yes, he did it." Delusional.
Oh nah, man, you can't.
So she get goofier today. She gets goofier today.
That's more than
one.
We gotta come on.
All right, so let me explain the story a little bit better, right?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm too. I'm real straight facts
yeah,
with it.
Yeah, yeah,
nigga,
yeah, 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 yeah. Let me explain the story happened. A little like bit it. Better. Okay, so apparently there was this guy and this girl. They were dealing with each other. I don't know if they were specifically in a boyfriend girlfriend committed relationship, but apparently,
so she said.
Apparently they were serious, or she thought that they were serious. And that relationship, I guess, ended or went left. Something happened. So she decided to take matters into her own hands to get some get back at bro. And throughout her thought process, she decided to not only text herself, as in she's acting like he's texting her, but she's really texting herself. And also texts herself as other women and him, saying that, you know, he knew that he had AIDS for 7 months, but, you know, he just had to have her. He saw her. A whole bunch of other stuff. Yeah. And it goes viral on the internet. They're literally, like, people, he said people pulled up to his house. Like, he was being attacked online. It went crazy viral.
Yo, that's criminal charges, bro.
She can go to jail for that?
I mean, absolutely. If it ain't a law, it need
I
to
hope,
be.
Right, I hope so. Because that's like defamation of character.
But that's like, I feel like that's the same way as saying somebody raped you and they really didn't.
Yeah. Yeah. Which, basically, you know, can't, yeah, that
you need to go to jail for that.
Can't be a charge.
That's, yeah, that's a lie. That that's a bold-faced lie. You need to go to jail.
That can't be a charge, too. That can't be a charge. I mean, you know, what's old girl that just did the whole getting kidnapped, or the little man was walking down this road? Right. Didn't she had to?
She going to jail, right?
Yeah, she had to face some criminal charges. Yeah. So, I mean, sometimes, man, people need to make examples of certain situations, because that's not cool.
Not at all.
At the end of the day, man, to put that on somebody's jacket, that's something that even though he's been clear and vindicated, he can never get off his jacket no matter what he does. Yeah,
and that's super serious, because I think, I may be repeating you, but if that was true and he knowingly gave her HIV without
that's a crime.
Her knowing, that's a crime.
Yeah.
Somebody at the University of Alabama Somebody at the University of Alabama, a football player, like, got criminal charges against him.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Right,
like,
now for doing
that. If that was true, that's a crime. So I feel like for even it being a lie, it should still be.
I feel like we should have known it was Kat from the jump, and she ain't had police.
I feel like if he
paperwork off jump.
If he lawyer up, I feel like the right lawyer could get him straight, though.
I mean, no. Like, at the end of the day, it's not going to be a civil suit, though. It has to be prosecuted from the state, though. Because he can get a lawyer all he wants. She ain't got no money to be taken. She ain't got nothing to be taken. So
it's nothing he can sue her for. My thing is, as people, should we believe people that come straight to the internet before they actually go to the police and file criminal?
Slippery slope.
Yeah, it is.
I don't think you can say yes or no.
I can't take you. I won't say I won't believe you. I can't take you serious until you actually.
So should the first thing that a person at anything that should be in this position do, go to the police or go to the internet?
Police.
I go to the police, obviously. Yeah.
But that, so I'm when not going to judge when the first, when the first the thing though. That you do is go to the internet, how can I believe you?
Because people make terrible decisions all the time, especially people in traumatized positions. So I can't just look at it as something in a vacuum and say just because you took it to the internet and made a decision that I think is ignorant, that you're just lying automatically. Now, I'm also not saying I'm just going to take your truth at face value.
But what justice are you getting when you go straight to the internet?
And then I think when people take stuff like that to the internet, right, a lot of people give them the benefit of the doubt. Right, because not only are you exposing someone else, you're now exposing yourself. So it's like people give those people the benefit of the doubt. Like, you wouldn't come to the internet with a lie on something of this stature. Like,
bullshit.
I mean, we know that. that's obvious. But
I feel as though people would come to the internet with more cap, even exposing itself, than going to the police. Because when you go into the police, you can't bullshit them. Because if you bullshit the police, you're going to jail for bullshitting them.
I mean,
you can go to the internet and bullshit the internet. Cool. There's no going to be no.
Nah, bro. Like, even.
That's his favorite word tonight, by the way.
For real, he's killing it. But I'm just saying, bro, like, especially as us being, like, black men, we cannot sit here and act like the criminal justice system always works in our favor.
I'm not saying that it works in our favor.
But then at that point, what do you do? Because a lot of times, even looking back on it, when the criminal justice system is not going to be in our favor, no matter who you are, no matter what angle you're looking at it, sometimes you do have to go to the media in order to get your story heard, in order to get things to be what it needs to be. We're not going to act like that's not true. So we can't judge
to the media, what is that going to do, though?
It's going to get your story heard. We're going to sit here and act like police is doing the right thing all the time? Like, 100% of the time? Like, come on. Like,
No, all right, getting your story heard, though, what is that going to do? Like,
it is going to bring attention to it so the police have to do what it is that they're supposed to do.
Yeah.
A lot of times we have to deal, especially, bro, there are people in positions of power that can shut all that shit down. Like, there was a Murdoch documentary about some motherfuckers in South Carolina that basically they had three generations of people that ran the like judicial system in a county.
Yeah, I heard about that shit. Therefore,
they had a son that was going crazy. He got drunk one night, drove a boat, had Shorty fly off the boat and killed Shorty. And then, like, they covered the whole thing up. So the only thing there is to do sometimes is go to the media to say, hey, they acting fucked up over here and I need y'all to know about it. Because sometimes the only pressure you can put on somebody is public pressure. That's all we got.
Message.
So I ain't here. If you got to do it, go do what you got to do. But stand on that, too.
I'll say the first thing you need to do is go to the media, though.
Man, sometimes that is what it is, dog. Sometimes the police not your friend.
If you can't go get help, then go to the media.
Hey,
but I feel as though go get real help first.
Sometimes you know real help. Yeah. Not, why are we going to act like that doesn't exist? With the real help you talking about not on our side.
Going to the police is always helpful because it ain't.
I can say that for us. You know how many
unsolved murders it is?
I ain't talking about unsolved murders right now. That's talking going about to the police.
Be that person.
No.
Nah,
it would mean the same thing.
Like, even like big events like that, being caught on camera, first thing you see it, you didn't see it on the news, you saw it on social media first, right?
Boom. What? Had a whole bombshell in that back pocket, put it right in front of you and said,
"Bow!" And that's in the back pocket, y'all.
Let's go. Right there. That is, be right that there. Person.
Dun dun dun.
What?
Tyrone. Right. Hey. Hey, that sword right. Got two sides on it, don't it?
Yeah.
I feel you on your other side because a lot of it be bullshit. Some of it be bullshit, but at the end of the day, you gotta deal with bullshit to get that real shit at the same time. So I'm good on both sides. Cause that truth gonna come to the light. That's what 2024 is showing.
Nah, for sure.
That truth coming to the light. All 2024, man. That's what it is. Hey.
And on that note, man. We appreciate y'all for tuning in to Live from the Lab, episode 34.
Hey, man, it was so live.
The Anonymous Takeover, man.
Yeah, anonymously took over.
Yeah. Bullshit.
The Anonymous Takeover, man. Know what I mean? Keep liking, commenting, subscribing.
Hey, man, let y'all know we give y'all the real, bro. We don't cut nothing. We don't edit nothing. Facts. We let y'all see exactly how it go down in here, man. So that's real, man. Y'all like, comment, share, subscribe. Let's go.
Peace.
Yeah.